G&D Audio presents an unabridged recording of Success Vitamins for a Positive Mind, Over 700 Mind Conditioners. Written by Dr. Napoleon Hill and Judith Williamson. Narrated by Chris Taylor. Introduction. Dr. Napoleon Hill is an expert in taking theory and resizing it into applicable practice for the layman. He is able to distill thought into short epigrams that he himself has labeled success vitamins for a daily dose of insight into how to succeed in today's complicated world. For businessmen and businesswomen alike who are watching their clocks but still need daily inspiration, this volume of over 700 success proverbs is ideal. By just reading and reflecting on a few epigrams, or even a page a day, you'll be conditioning your mind for positive outcomes. These success vitamins can contribute to your healing financially, mentally, physically, spiritually, socially, and emotionally today and throughout the year. Topics are random, but the messages are always pertinent to concerns of your life, especially on the job. When thoughts are directed toward positive outcomes, positive behaviors follow. Today's students of self-help accept the value of affirmations. Sometimes these short sayings are called auto-suggestions and even self-hypnosis. But regardless of the name, the result is that when read or repeated out loud with enthusiasm, they work to modify behavior. These success vitamins can supply the missing ingredient that conditions a person for success, one short saying at a time. Each saying is a truism that expresses an idea that sometimes has been overlooked, forgotten, or covered up for the sake of convenience. When you read these, you will detect the eternal wisdom of the sayings. The preface by Dr. Hill is well worth your study time, too. In his typical style, he gets to the heart of the issue by stating that harmony is what is important and needed most now in both our inner and outer worlds. He compares this to the harmony infinite intelligence has placed in the universal workings of cosmic habit force from the beginning of time. It is interesting to note that Dr. Hill finds harmony lacking only in mankind, and he reminds us that it is better to mirror the flow of the universe than to oppose it for any and all of our purposes. The advice is as sound today as it was when he wrote his findings decades ago. In using and applying this material, you will alter the blueprint of your life for the better. By just considering the ideas Dr. Hill crystallizes in these success epigrams, you will be attending a school for mind conditioning. Recalling that we get what we focus on, paying attention to these tidbits of wisdom aptly called success vitamins, you will fortify your body, mind, and spirit in beneficial ways. Finally, when you use what you have learned actively in your everyday life, you will not lose the lesson, but internalize it, literally ingest it. In the past, when doctors visited homes to minister to the sick, they carried a well-stocked black doctor's bag with medicines and healing instruments. If you consider this book of epigrams to be part of your medical arsenal for success, you will never be without a handy cure for whatever ails you. Place these vitamins in your success medicine bag. Take a minimum of 2 success vitamins daily with plenty of thought. You will be the better for it. Be your very best always, Judy Williamson. Success Vitamins for a Positive Mind, Over 700 Mind Conditioners by Dr. Napoleon Hill. Help thy brother's boat across, and lo, thine own hath reached the shore. These proverbs are based on the experience of more than 500 of the outstanding leaders who have been responsible for the development of the American way of life. They have been proved sound and practical because they have worked successfully for those who tried them, and they have been reduced to the fewest words possible for the benefit of all who sincerely wish to find their places in the world. The collection was prepared especially for students of the philosophy, with the hope that each person who reads it may be enriched in body, mind, and spirit. For as the great philosopher Socrates has said, wisdom adorns riches and softens poverty. Author's Preface. This collection of epigrams is a concentrated presentation of the entire philosophy of success, prepared for the man who reads as he runs. Its purpose is to aid men and women in the development of a personal philosophy of life that will bring them economic security and peace of mind in proportion to their desires and talents. The most important thing in life is harmony in human relationships. Friction among men is more costly than friction in machinery. This philosophy, if followed, will condition one's mind to get along with others in a spirit of friendliness. It will give one a success consciousness, which is so essential for material success in every calling. Life is short at best, too short to justify any man in devoting any portion of his time to the creation of friction between himself and others. One man could not have set the entire world on fire if friction among men had not prepared the way for him. Let us make our association one of harmony and brotherly love. Let us get ahead by helping one another in the spirit of the Master, as he expressed it in the Sermon on the Mount. All things whatsoever ye would that men should do unto ye, do you even so unto them. The world has all but emasculated itself through friction among men. For our own sake, and the sake of our children, let us now reverse the rule of friction, and make our portion of the world one of harmony. The benefits of harmony have been mirrored for us in everything the Creator has given us, save only in the relationships of men. The stars that hang up there in the heavens move swiftly and silently, but never get out of their paths. The seasons of the year come and go with harmonious precision, and the sun rises in the east and sets in the west with daily punctuality and harmony. The beasts of the jungle and the birds of the air go about their duties in a spirit of harmony, serving as a mighty reprimand to men who neglect to respect one another's rights. The whole world about us cries out in a language we cannot ignore, a language of pain and failure and fear, warning us that God's way is a way of harmony among men. Let us heed this warning before the preset world chaos is followed by greater disaster, for surely no one is so ignorant as to not recognize that the man who injures his neighbor injures himself more, that a day of reckoning must come to every man who tries to get, without first giving, a fair equivalent in return. The day of the go-getter is past, the day of the go-giver is at hand. This philosophy was taken from the experiences of men who recognize that he profits most who serves best. It is a natural and a healthful human instinct for a man to desire to make life pay on the best terms possible. Experience of the most successful men this nation has produced shows clearly that all constructive achievements and all individual success depend upon a positive mental attitude. And the thing that goes farthest in giving one a positive mental attitude is harmony within one's own mind and harmony in all human relationships. Harmony calls for self-discipline, a lot of it. But the man who takes the time to develop harmony through self-discipline thereby conditions his mind to attract the better things of life, which he may set his mind upon. These proverbs are mind conditioners. Read them thoughtfully and make them your own. Then observe how other people definitely and quickly give you their friendly cooperation. It is one of the great mysteries of life that the mind attracts the physical counterpart of that which it dwells upon. Think of others in terms of brotherly love, and they'll think of you in the same spirit, although they might not always be conscious of the reason why they do so. The circumstances of a man's life fit the pattern of his mental attitude, just as surely as the sun rises in the east and sets in the west. Make your mental attitude right, and lo, the world around you will become harmonious and cooperative. Opportunities for self-advancement will present themselves. Promotions will come to you voluntarily. Those who dislike you will change their attitude and begin to like you. Griping may be sometimes justified, but it never pays. For griping is an outward expression of a negative mental attitude. If you can grasp this truth and make use of it, you'll be as wise as the sages and rich in values that make life worth living. You cannot always control other people's actions towards you, but you can and you should control your reactions towards others, for this will, in time, set the pattern in all your human relationships, which will influence others to your way of thinking. How do I know these truths? I know them because I've tried them and I found that they work. And, being one who loves his fellow men, I crave the privilege of sharing these blessings with all who are ready and willing to adopt them and use them. This book is printed for everyone who will read the epigrams carefully and recognize that they provide sound counsel for those who are willing to give in order to get the values of life that make people successful and happy. I am a practical realist who has worked his way upward from the bottom by applying the philosophy on which these epigrams are based. I'm a humanitarian who sincerely desires to inspire my students with the spirit of harmony and the mental attitude toward one another that will make life a joy and not a burden. Yours for personal victory, Dr. Napoleon Hill. Whatever the mind can conceive and believe, the mind can achieve. Napoleon Hill. Let us be thankful for our blessings. Let us express our gratitude for what we already possess, rather than complain because of what we wish, for it is a well-known fact that prayers of gratitude for the blessings one possesses attract still greater blessings. Let us supplement our present blessings by a spirit of friendly cooperation, remembering that it was this spirit of thought and deed which gave us our American freedom and riches. Let us encourage leaders to use their talents and their financial resources in making this a greater world, so our children and the yet unborn generations may enjoy blessings and freedom. Lastly, may it be the prayer of each of us that from among this generation of our youth, there shall rise a new core of leaders who will, by their talents and their personal ambitions, provide us with the sort of opportunities which have been provided in the past by such men as Henry Ford, Thomas A. Edison, Andrew Carnegie, the Wright brothers, Captain Eddie Rickenbacker, Henry J. Kaiser, and R.G. Letourneau. For these are the sort of men who have given us our way of life.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.